Hello, Cancer. Welcome to Zen Tarot. My name is Julie. I am doing zodiac energy readings for the right now Cancer. So whenever you come across this video, that is when you are meant to see it. Let's get right into it, Cancer. I'm really curious to see how Cancers are doing. Let's get a Moon Oracle Tarot card for Cancer. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like, share, and subscribe buttons. That really helps my channel get going. What do you need to release, Cancer? What is it that's on your mind, that's in your heart? Something is gnawing at you and you need to release it. This is the waning moon, so really think about that. What is it that you need to release? What is it, Cancer? Let's get you an animal spirit card here. The Swan, so you are seeing two perspectives here. You are trying to make a decision here, trying to see what needs to go and what can stay here. You're feeling kind of like an imbalance here. So there's something that does need to release. There's something that's got to go. So this is kind of the Justice card as well too here. So water card, and there is something that needs to go. Something that has been hard for you to let go of. You've been hanging on to it. Call, so judgment. So yeah, there is absolutely balance that's needed here. There's something that's got to go. There's something that needs to be called out. There's an energy here that seems to be imbalanced, and only you can bring it back into balance. Yeah, by letting the burdens go, release something here. There's something on your mind that really needs to go. There's a thought process, a continuing of a thought. It's almost obsessive that you keep thinking about it over and over and over again. Make the decision, Cancer. Make the decision and let it go. Just release those burdens. Just walk away from those burdens. And I saw the world wanted to pop out there, so new cycle coming in for you. That's, oh yeah, look at that. So yeah, when you wouldn't release it, when you kept thinking about it over and over and over again, look at these two tens, but the tower comes out and the tower just brings it all down for you. So you were not releasing it. You were not letting it go. You just kept thinking about it over and over again. So spirit comes in and they transform and they take it all down. This is a hard energy to be in the mind, but the best thing that could happen, because we get so caught up in what we're thinking and the what ifs and the worst case scenarios. And you needed to walk away from that. You needed to find some hope, some kind of future for you, some kind of new beginning for you. And so spirit comes in and says, you know what, we're gonna have to do this for you because it's just too hard for you. It's just too burdensome for you to keep thinking about this over and over and over again. You've been keeping those thoughts really, really close. You have not been revealing what's been going on in your mind. Fear of rejection, fear of something. You had some kind of fear of letting go of those thoughts or releasing those thoughts. And the tower comes in to say, you know what, we're just going to break it all down for you. We're just going to give you this mental breakdown so that you can start over, so you can stop being so introverted and kind of get back out there and start speaking your truth and start revealing how you feel and just start walking away from that thought process, that whatever was holding you back here. That brings in the Six of Wands, so look at that. So as soon as you do, as soon as you let it all go, let these burdens go, people are listening to you, people respect you now, they put you up on that pedestal, they are honoring you now and your thoughts. So you can really refine what you were thinking here with the Four of Pentacles. You can reveal it to the masses, and now you're helping them move on from this energy here, because the masses, the collective, is really caught up in their thoughts here. They're afraid, they've been fed fear, and so were you, but now you're stepping out on that stage to be the life coach now, to be the leader, to say, we don't have to do it this way. We don't have to live on fear. We can live on hope and dream again. We can dream again. So with the Three of Cups in your heart space, you're ready to celebrate that new beginning. You're ready to start over with friends. You're ready to get out. You're ready to let go of the fear. So you're not listening to those fear conversations anymore. You're not listening to the what ifs and the what should be's. Now you're just celebrating the now, and you're living life in the now. You're finally just letting life be good to you. Be good to you. You're not letting it be scary anymore. And you're stopping with the planning. You were planning and planning and planning, you know, and life is what happens to us while we're busy planning for it. And you realize that. So you're seeing everything differently. You're seeing things that you never thought possible. So there is a new beginning here with the tower coming down and then this new idea coming in, this new way of thinking about things. So it's something you never thought possible with the When Pigs Fly Here card coming out. So some kind of friendship is going to really blossom here after this moment of breakdown, of loss, of I'm letting it all go. You're going to go out with friends. You're going to say, yeah, I had to just surrender it all. I had to release it all. And that's when this new idea came in, this new way of being, this new way of thinking. So now you're thinking differently. You're processing things differently. You're not feeding into that fear anymore. You're celebrating it. And the Knight of Pentacles comes out to show that that's the right way to go, that you are on the right path, that abundance will follow you this way. And instead of holding on to your finances, instead of not wanting to spend one dime because of all the fear that's been fed to you, you know, inflation and markets crashing and everything falling to shit, you're like, you know what, I just have to take control now. I'm taking my pentacle, I'm walking away, and look how the pentacles fall you right into the stardom card here. So you're starting over with some kind of stardom here. You have a fan base, you have a following, people that are really listening to you and how you got through this energy. So that is beautiful. And the King of Pentacles definitely wanted to come out. I saw it earlier, wanted to pop out. So you are stable now. You are secure. You are feeling like a superstar now. Now nothing can stop you. You had to let it all fall away in order to come into this energy here with the Six of Wands and the King of Pentacles. So get out with friends and really start talking about this new idea of yours, this new perspective of yours after you let everything fall away. And it's going to really start from there. It's really going to start from there. You're going to come into a new idea that you never thought possible. Two Kings. So look how stable you are. Look how you're believing in magic again with that dragon. You've got the wisdom now with the owl, and you've got spirit guiding this too as well. So you are really, really coming into your own here with some valuable information that you have to share with the collective now, that you need to reveal now and reveal without fear. So you need to reveal with hope now, and that comes after some healing too. This is your foundation down here. So you did some healing, you did some releasing, you walked away from your burdens, you're letting up now. You're not holding on to those finances. You're not so scared about money leaving you. Now money's going to start following you with this new fan base that you have with these new followers. And that's beautiful. That comes after some healing. So that comes after releasing. And that's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful reading, Cancer. I love this. Yeah, there's been competition. There's been stress. There's been some heartache here. So you had to really go through it. You were confused. You were, look at that. Moon, Five of Wands, and Five of Swords. So yeah, talk about confusion. Talk about competition. Talk about people squawking in your ear and saying, it's all going to be horrible. It's like Eeyore energy from Winnie the Pooh. Like, it's never going to work. They were telling you. They were like, you suck, you're no good, we're all going to die, it's end times. And that just gave you a headache, and you were confused about all of it. So you walked away from that, and you're like, you know what, I'm going to find hope. I'm going to sow these seeds, and I'm going to create my own future without fear, without being afraid of the future, and living today for tomorrow. You're like, I just got to start really, really making this happen, and only I can do that. And you're taking full control. You're letting all of that negative energy go and fear go, and you're really starting to open up with your thoughts, your ideas, with your passions. You're doing this from the roots up. So talk about being the leader now. That's why you're coming into that Six of Wands energy, because you are letting all the fear go. You're letting all the fear go, and the masses need this. The collective needs this to be able to have some hope again, to be able to relax and put their feet up and go out and celebrate with friends without that fear. And it looks like financial fear because of all the pentacles here. But no more for you, no more for you. You're like, it is what it is. Spirit's got my back. I don't have to worry about money anymore. And even if I don't have a dime right now, that can change. Energy changes so quickly. So you're realizing that now. You're making the judgment call now. You're like, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to imagine this future where I'm penniless and broke and homeless. I'm going to imagine a future where people are paying me for what I have to say, and they respect me for what I have to say, and I'm giving them hope instead of fear. And that's the way to shift the collective. That's the way to shift out of this scared energy. And you're the one that's going to be doing it. You are the leader here. You're going to take the lead, and you're going to lead the collective out of this fear somehow, some way, through social media, through work, through getting out there on the street and saying it's okay, everything's okay, we can change this, we can shift this, and you're the one to do it. You are absolutely the one to do it. So good for you, Cancer. Good for you. I loved this reading. All right, if you love this reading, don't forget to hit the share and the like and the subscribe button, and I will greatly appreciate it. If you'd like a personal reading, then I will leave my email address in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching, Cancer. I hope you have a fantastic day. Be kind, be well, and be charitable.